Howdy, everybody. It has been a while since I posted on the tube for you, but I'm still around. I want to tell you guys a really cool story today with lots of mystery. Last week, I was filling up my truck, and then behind me, I see this beautiful Harley-Davidson Panhead. And I start talking to the guy, and it was a 1948, and he's had it for close to 30 years. He told me he rode it all the time, and it reminded me of all these great bikes I saw at this museum last summer called the Wheels Through Time, and it's in Maggie Valley, North Carolina. And the one bike that it made me think of was this Traub, a 1916 Traub, T-R-A-U-B. It's like a one-of-a-kind, rare bike. It's the only one in the world. So today I'm going to tell you a little bit about it. Now, what's funny is, if one or two things change from the story I'm about to tell you, I could be riding a Traub today instead of a Harley-Davidson or an Indian. In 1967, there was a Chicago fireman who was doing renovations on his house. And as he was going through and fixing things, he came across some plumbing issues. And he called a plumber in, and the plumber told him, hey, there's no way I could fix this without getting access to some of the piping behind the wall. So he said, the only way we're going to be able to do that is take off this brick wall and get behind it so we could fix this stuff. So as they got rid of the wall, they discovered this beautiful 1916 Traub in pretty damn good conditions. The only thing that was wrong with it, the tires were flat, and they probably had to do some cleaning after 50 years. But other than that, it was in pretty solid condition. Back in 1916, there were over 200 different manufacturers of motorcycles. The popularity was just kicking up and taking off. I mean, everybody and their mothers were making them. Fast forward about 15, 20 years later after the Great Depression, and there's only two that remained. And that was Harley-Davidson and Indian. So what makes the Traub so special? Well, the Traub itself was years ahead of its time. I mean, some of the tech that was in this bike wasn't even used by other manufacturers till like 15, 20 years later. And the Traub, it had a 3-speed transmission, had an 80 cubic inch V-twin engine, the 1,287 cc's. It got up to speeds close to 85 miles per hour. It had this very innovative brake system. It was 90% handmade and machined very well. It was definitely one of its kind. Back in 1967, they wanted to find the original owner of the house to explain how the hell this bike got behind the wall. So after doing some digging and research, they ended up finding this very old man, and he was in his 80s, and he told this story about back in 1916, he had a son, and his son had stolen a motorcycle, and he came home with it. The dad was so pissed off and fired up, he turned around and made him join up the war, and at the time, that was World War I. Now, unfortunately, the son never came back, so we presume he died. But what we never find out is how that bike ended up in the wall. Do we think that the boy did it before he went off to the war because he was pissed off about it? Do we think the father did it to teach his boy a lesson? We'll never know. That's part of the mystery of this whole thing. The bike changed ownership several times over the next 13 years. Then in 1980, on the set of a movie called Blues Brothers, there was this gentleman by the name of Bud Eakins. And if you don't know who Bud Eakins is, there's an American actor named Steve McQueen. Bud Eakins was his personal stuntman. Now, if you ever saw, there was a movie called The Great Escape with Steve McQueen. There's a famous scene at the end where he jumps over this big wall. That was Bud Eakins on the actual motorcycle. So he ended up purchasing it. And then it changed hands a couple more times. And finally, it ended up with a gentleman by the name of Dale Waxler. Dale is the curator of the Wheels Through Time Museum in Maggie Valley, North Carolina. That's where it sits today. And to anybody's knowledge, this is the only Traub ever made. Pretty cool, huh? Some smart people wanted to find out the origins of Traub. Who made it? Where did it come from? Whoever it was very knowledgeable and skilled. So they did some digging. And then they found out, and they're probably 90% sure it's this one man. His name's Gottlieb Richard Traub. And Gottlieb was born in the late 1800s in Chicago. And they think there was like three or four things that kind of prove that it's this guy. So first thing, in 1910, when they looked at the census card of Gottlieb Traub, it listed his occupation as toolmaker. Then they looked at his draft card, so this is around 1917, 1918. It listed as experimental machinist. So they put the two and two together and said, okay, this guy's an experimental machinist. He was a toolmaker, so he has the skills and knowledge to easily produce a bike. But there were some other things that really proved it. So in 1907, there was this motorcycle publication. I don't remember the name of it, But there was this letter in there, and they found it. It was written by a gentleman named Gottlieb Traut, T-R-A-U-T, not T-R-A-U-B. So we think it's just a printing error. Instead of the B, they typed the T. But in this letter, he sent a letter to this magazine saying, hey, I just want to show you the bike I'm working on. And he sent a couple pictures. And the picture of the 1907 bike that's in that magazine looks very similar, close to identical, as the 1916 Traub that they found behind the wall. So in theory, what they say is over the next 9 years since 1907, he perfected that machine to what it was, to the bike that they found in 1967. I have a couple questions. The bike that was found in 1967 isn't that far from Gottlieb's address back in 1916. Why didn't he fill out a police report? There's absolutely no record of any police report on that motor, on a stolen motorcycle. Second, why didn't he ever try to rebuild it? We found out from that research that he ended up dying in 1952, a full 15 years before the bike was found in 1967. You think that he put all that blood, sweat, and tears into that bike. Why didn't he try to build another one? Was he that pissed off and that distraught because it was stolen? Of course, it probably ruined his day, but you think he would have wrote some notes down? Who knows? That leads to the, you know, bigger mystery. What I do know, if you want to see this thing up close and personal, go visit the Wheels Through Time Museum in Maggie Valley, North Carolina. It's right in the middle of the Smoky Mountains. Beautiful museum. Best way to describe it, it's kind of like a motorcycle's wet dream, right? And just think, if one thing could have changed, like if he didn't get that bike stolen, could we be riding a Traub today instead of a Harley Davidson or Indian? I mean, it's kind of wild just to think one action caused that much of a reaction and the man never built another motorcycle again. But we'll never know. It's a mystery. Well, I hope you enjoyed the story. I really enjoyed reading about it and learning about it when I was at the museum. Hope you liked it. Please leave a comment. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. I definitely appreciate it. As always, be good, and I'll talk to you guys soon.